Good morning everyone. Myself Rupa, lecturer in chemistry. Today I am dealing with the topic P block elements, continuation of that in the first session what I have completed. So today we will discuss regarding the chemical properties. In chemical properties, first chemical properties is oxidation state. Oxidation state. Here the P block elements, that is the, here we are discussing the 15 group elements. 15 group elements exhibit two types of oxidation state, that is negative oxidation state and positive oxidation state. See, first one is let us study the negative oxidation state. Nitrogen exhibit negative oxidation state of -3. Negative oxidation state of -3. Nitrogen is more stable with -3 as its oxidation state here. As you move from nitrogen to bismuth, the oxidation state stability decreases. The negative oxidation stability decreases here from nitrogen to bismuth, because due to increase in atomic size. As the atomic size increases here, negative oxidation stability decreases. Nitrogen is more stable with the oxidation state of -3 because of its small atomic size. Because of its small atomic size and high electronegativity. Because of small atomic size and high electronegativity value of 3. Next comes the positive oxidation state. Second one is positive oxidation state. 15 group elements exhibit positive oxidation state of +3 and +5. Here +5 oxidation state stability, +5 oxidation state stability decreases from nitrogen to bismuth. Here its stability decreases from nitrogen to bismuth here due to increase in its atomic size, whereas the +3 oxidation state stability increases from nitrogen to bismuth. Here because of inert pair effect, because the reason is due to inert pair effect here. Some of the compounds also exhibit +5 oxidation state. Only few compounds like SbF5 and BiF5, they exhibit stable in +5 oxidation state. Only few compounds they will exhibit here. Nitrogen, it is having an oxidation state. Nitrogen exhibit oxidation state of +1, +2 and +4 with oxygen. Whereas phosphorus exhibit oxidation state of +1 and +4 with the oxygen. This is about the oxidation state. First chemical property is the oxidation state. Second chemical property is the, second one is reactivity towards hydrogen. 15 group elements, they react with hydrogen and they form the hydrides of the type EH3, where E is nitrogen, phosphorus, arsenic, antimony and bismuth. These hydrides, they are strong reducing agent, inflammable in nature as well as they are poisonous in nature. So we shall study some of these properties like thermal stability. Thermal stability decreases. Thermal stability decreases due to increase in EH
bond length.
Due to increase in EH bond length, the thermal stability decreases here. NH3 is more stable than PH3, than ASH3, than SBH3, than the BiH3. If you see from nitrogen to bismuth, the atomic size increases. Due to increase in the atomic size, what happens to EH bond length? EH bond length also increases. But what happens to thermal stability? Thermal stability decreases from NH3 to BiH3 due to increase in the EH bond length. Next comes here the reducing power. Reducing power increases from NH3 to BiH3. Reducing power increases from NH3 to BiH3. Due to increase in the size here, its reducing power increases. NH3, it is a mild reducing agent, while BiH3, it is a strong reducing agent. BiH3 is a strong reducing agent. This is about the reducing power. Next comes here, the third one is the basic character. Basic character or the basicity. What is the basic character here? Basic character means it is a tendency to donate the lone pair of electrons. The tendency to donate lone pair of electron decreases from NH3 to BiH3. The tendency to donate electrons decreases from NH3 to BiH3. This SBH3 and BiH3, almost they are same here. The tendency to donate electron decreases, hence here the basic character also decreases from NH3 to BiH3. NH3 is more basic than compared with the BiH3. All these hydrides, EH3, all the hydrides, they are having a pyramidal structure. They are having a pyramidal structure here. This is regarding the reactivity towards the hydrogen. Next comes here reactivity towards the oxygen. Reactivity towards the oxygen atom here. 15 group elements, they react with oxygen and they form two types of oxides of the type E2O3 and E2O5. Let us see some of the oxides of nitrogen. Oxides of nitrogen. Nitrogen exhibits oxides of the type N2O3, N2O5, NO, NO2. Here, if we see higher oxidation state, higher oxidation state is more acidic. Is more acidic than lower oxidation state. Higher oxidation state is more acidic than lower oxidation state. If we see the stability also, the stability decreases here. The stability decreases from higher oxidation to the lower oxidation state with increase in atomic number. As atomic number increases here, the stability decreases from higher oxidation state to the lower oxidation state. Here the oxides, if we see the oxides here, higher oxidation state are more acidic than the lower oxidation state, and here higher oxidation state is more acidic than the lower oxidation state. Here lower oxidation state is less acidic, means it is more basic in nature. If we see the E2O3 oxides for nitrogen and phosphorus, E2O3 of nitrogen and phosphorus. They are acidic in nature and arsenic and antimony. They are amphoteric in nature, and bismuth is basic in nature. Here, from nitrogen to bismuth, the metallic character increases. From nitrogen to bismuth, the basicity also increases. Here, the metallic character and basicity increases. Metallic character and basicity increases. Both the metallic character and basicity increases from nitrogen to bismuth. Nitrogen and phosphorus are acidic in nature. Arsenic, antimony are amphoteric in nature, whereas bismuth is a basic in nature. Hence, the basic character as well as the metallic character increases from nitrogen to bismuth. This is about the reactivity towards the oxygen. Next comes here the reactivity towards the halogens. Reactivity towards the halogens. 15 group elements, they react with halogen and they form trihalide EX3 and EX5. It will form a trihalide and a pentahalide in nature. All the elements will form trihalides here and pentahalides, but except nitrogen. Nitrogen does not form the pentahalide here. Nitrogen does not form pentahalides. Why it will not form pentahalides means because due to absence of d orbitals. Due to absence of d orbitals, it cannot form the pentahalide. Nitrogen, it is having a covalency of maximum is 4. It cannot expand its covalency beyond 4, that is 5 or 6. If it can expand its covalency 5, it can exhibit pentahalide. Since it cannot expand its covalency as a 5 because of the absence of vacant d orbital. Hence, nitrogen does not exhibit pentahalides. Except nitrogen, all these elements, 15th group elements, they exhibit the trihalides as well as pentahalides. Nitrogen will exhibit the trihalides. Among the trihalides, NF3 is more stable. Among all the trihalides here, NF3 is more stable. Here if you see, it's a covalent here, nature. Trihalides and pentahalide, both are covalent in nature. But when you compare the covalent here, pentahalide are more covalent in nature than compared with the trihalide. They are also covalent, but compared with trihalide, pentahalides are more covalent in nature than the trihalides. All the trihalides and pentahalides are covalent in nature except one, except BiF3. BiF3 is not covalent in nature. Here BiF3 is not covalent in nature. It is ionic in nature. It is ionic in nature. This is all reactivity towards the halogens. Next comes here the reactivity towards the metals. Reactivity towards the metals. Here, the 15 group elements react with metals and they form binary compounds. They form the binary compounds. Here, their oxidation state of these binary compounds is, they exhibit oxidation state of -3. For example, here Ca3P2. Ca3P2 is calcium phosphide. Ca is +2. Phosphorus exhibit what is oxidation state here? They exhibit -3. So example is calcium phosphide. Similarly, here Ca3N2. C Ca is plus 2, N is minus 3. They exhibit minus 3 oxidation state. These elements, 15 group. The name of this compound is calcium nitride. Magnesium Mg3, Bi2. Mg is plus 2, Bi is plus minus 3. It is known as magnesium bismuthide. Magnesium bismuthide. Zinc Zn plus 2, Zn3 Sb2, zinc antimonide. These are some of the binary compounds formed by 15 group elements. This completes the chemical properties of the 15 group elements. Let us see some of the questions here. Generally they ask in the exam. First one, though nitrogen is having oxidation state of plus 5. Though nitrogen is having oxidation state of plus 5, it does not exhibit, pentahalide. Give reason. Though nitrogen is having oxidation state of plus 5, it does not exhibit the pentahalide. You know, nitrogen solution for this nitrogen, what is the principal quantum number for nitrogen is 2. So nitrogen is having 2 orbital, one s, and it is having 3p orbitals. It is having 1s and 3p orbitals, hence its covalency is only 4. Since its covalency is 4, why? Because due to absence of d orbitals, due to absence of vacant d orbitals, it cannot expand its covalency as 5. Since it is not having a covalency of 5, so hence nitrogen cannot exhibit as a pentahalide. This is one question. Second one. pH 3 is nothing but phosphine. pH 3 is having lower boiling point than ammonia. Give reason or why it is having lower boiling point. pH 3 is a phosphine, NH3 is ammonia. Ammonia is having high boiling point than phosphine, or phosphine is having lower boiling point than ammonia. Because in ammonia contains, it is associated with intermolecular hydrogen bonding. It is having intermolecular hydrogen bonding in liquid state. Ammonia is associated with intermolecular hydrogen bonding in liquid state, whereas phosphine pH 3, it does not contain the intermolecular hydrogen bonding. Since it does not contain the intermolecular hydrogen bonding in liquid state, it is having less boiling point than the ammonia. Here phosphine is having a boiling point of 186 Kelvin, ammonia is having a boiling point of 238 Kelvin. Ammonia is having high boiling point due to the presence of intermolecular hydrogen bonding, whereas phosphine is having lower boiling point due to the absence of intermolecular hydrogen bonding. This is all about the chemical properties and some of the questions we have discussed. Next comes the dinitrogen. Next one is dinitrogen. Dinitrogen, di means 2, formula is N2. N2 is known as di nitrogen. So first we shall prepare the dinitrogen on a large scale, that is manufacture of dinitrogen. How we can manufacture this dinitrogen? Manufacture of dinitrogen N2, that to liquid dinitrogen. We can manufacture this liquid nitrogen. The source for this liquid nitrogen is the air which is present in the atmosphere. By using the fractional distillation, we can manufacture the liquid dinitrogen. So on fractional distillation of air, when the temperature reaches 77.2 Kelvin, this is 77.2 Kelvin is the boiling point of liquid dinitrogen. So during fractional distillation, when the temperature reaches 77.2 Kelvin, liquid dinitrogen, it is in the form of gas, it escapes out and gets first distilled off. Remaining is the liquid oxygen which is present here. Later on, the liquid oxygen is also collected when it starts boiling, when it reaches a boiling point of 90 Kelvin. In this way, we get liquid dinitrogen as well as liquid dioxygen. While preparing liquid dinitrogen, we get the byproduct is liquid dioxygen. This is also economically important. Hence, this method is used generally for the manufacture of liquid nitrogen on a large scale, because the byproduct obtained is also very useful, liquid dioxygen. We shall study some of the laboratory method of preparation of dinitrogen. First laboratory method of preparation of dinitrogen is by heating with aqueous solution of ammonium chloride and sodium nitrate, NaNO2. By heating a solution of aqueous solution of ammonium chloride and sodium nitrite, here we get a dinitrogen N2 in the form of a gas. Along with that, we get NaCl, that is sodium chloride, and a water molecule. In this way, we can prepare the nitrogen gas. While preparing the nitrogen gas, here we get some of the impurities as NO and HNO3. We get impurities like NO and HNO3. How to remove this one? We have to pass through a solution of concentrated sulfuric acid. Here, when we pass through a solution of concentrated sulfuric acid, along with that, small amount of K2CR2O7 is also added. In this way, we can remove the NO and HNO3 impurities which is present while preparing the nitrogen gas. This is the first method. Second method here. You know, K2CR2O7, it is known as potassium dichromate. Instead of potassium, if I write NH4, it becomes NH4 twice CR2O7. That is ammonium dichromate. On heating ammonium dichromate, we get nitrogen N2. Along with that, we get water molecules here and CR2O3. This is one method. And the third method is, while preparing the third method, we get the pure dinitrogen. Third method, we get pure dinitrogen in this method. Using some of the azides here, like barium azide. You know, barium is Ba+2. Azide means it is N3-. So it becomes BaN3 twice. Because Ba is +2, N3 is -. So it will form BaN3 twice. It is known as barium azide. Barium azide. Barium azide on heating you get barium. Barium, it is a solid, it remains here, and the nitrogen, it escapes in the form of a gas. This is the best method to prepare the dinitrogen, because one is a solid and another is a gas. Easily it escapes out in the form of a gas. We get the pure nitrogen in this method. Next comes the physical properties of dinitrogen. Physical properties of dinitrogen. Physical properties of dinitrogen. Dinitrogen N2. It is a colorless, odorless, and tasteless. It is a colorless, odorless, and tasteless gas. It is non-toxic in nature. Non-toxic in nature. Here, if you see the isotopes, you will get two isotopes for nitrogen. That is in the 7N14 as well as N15. Both the isotopes, two isotopes of this nitrogen, both are stable here. Both the isotopes are stable here. Next, fourth comes here. It's a freezing point. Nitrogen, it is having a freezing point of 63.2 Kelvin, and it is having a boiling point of 77.2 Kelvin. Freezing point of 63.2 Kelvin and boiling point of 77.2 Kelvin. This is about the physical properties. Next, we shall move towards the chemical properties. Chemical properties of dinitrogen. In chemical properties of dinitrogen, here, first chemical property N2, you know that between the nitrogen, there is a triple bond is present, and it is having a high bond dissociation enthalpy, high bond dissociation enthalpy of 941 kilojoule per mole. So at room temperature, N2 is an inert gas. Nitrogen, it is a, N2 is an inert gas when at room temperature. Because of high bond dissociation enthalpy, N2 is an inert gas at room temperature. But when you take the nitrogen at high temperatures, it reacts with the metals. Reaction with metals, that too, what type of metals here? Electropositive metals. Electropositive metals. Dinitrogen N2 reacts with the electropositive metals. When the reaction takes place? When temperature is high. At high temperatures, the reaction takes place at high temperatures here. The nitrogen N2 gas, dinitrogen, reacts with lithium to form Li3N is nothing but lithium nitride. At high temperatures, nitrogen reacts with lithium to form lithium nitride. Another is here with calcium, it will react, as well as it will react with the magnesium. Magnesium reacts with dinitrogen at high temperature to form Mg3N2. That is, Mg3N2 is nothing but magnesium nitride. This reaction takes place when the temperature is at high. This is the second one, chemical property. Third is, reacts with the non-metals. Third one is, reaction with the non-metals. Dinitrogen reacts with non-metals like oxygen, hydrogen. But here the condition is at high temperature. Reactions takes place at high temperature only. If it is low temperature, it does not react here, because to break the bond between the nitrogen atoms, high bond dissociation enthalpy is required. It occurs only when the temperature is very high here. Dinitrogen N2 directly reacts with the hydrogen. Directly reacts with the hydrogen to form ammonia, NH3. Nitrogen, dinitrogen directly reacts with the oxygen to form NO, that is nitric oxide. These are some of the chemical properties of the dinitrogen. After the chemical properties, we study regarding the uses of the dinitrogen here. The last part of this is the uses of dinitrogen. So, where this dinitrogen is used? Uses of dinitrogen here. Just now we saw that dinitrogen is used in the manufacture of ammonia, that is NH3. Dinitrogen is used in the manufacture of ammonia. Dinitrogen is used in the manufacture of ammonia, first one. Dinitrogen N2 gas, here N2 gas, it provides an inert atmosphere. Since N2 gas provides an inert atmosphere, it is used in the metallurgical operations, that is in the preparation of steel and iron. Preparation of steel and iron, N2 gas is used as an inert atmosphere. Nitrogen, here it is used as a nitrogen, liquid dinitrogen, N2. Liquid dinitrogen, it is used as a cooling purpose in the refrigerators. Here in the refrigerators, liquid dinitrogen, it is used to preserve the food items as well as the biological materials. Liquid dinitrogen, it is used to fill the mercury thermometers here. Along with the mercury, nitrogen in the form of a gas, it is used in the thermometers. You know that in the thermometers, the mercury is there at the bottom of the thermometer. Along with the mercury that is in the tube, nitrogen gas is filled. Because these type of thermometers, generally they are used to measure the high temperature. They are used to measure the high temperature. This liquid nitrogen, it is used in the cryosurgery. Cryosurgery. What is this cryosurgery means? Here, generally, the tumorous cells which are formed on the skin, external portion of the skin, here, while removing this one, here a cold atmosphere is provided so that we have to freeze the damaged or the tumorous cells. To freeze this one, the liquid dinitrogen is used. So this liquid dinitrogen, it freezes the tumorous cells or the damaged cells. Later on, the surgery is carried out. This type of surgery, which is carried out in cold conditions, is known as cryosurgery. It is carried out using the liquid dinitrogen. These are the uses of the liquid dinitrogen. So in the next class, we'll study regarding the ammonia. Thank you.